Hi, I'm Amanda Marco, and I'm going to do a poem called Nebraskan Girl Canadian Tendencies. I was born in Lincoln, Nebraska, raised in the northern regions of Quebec, brought up by a frostbitten pair of people who loved me enough to expose me to harsh winters at a young age. They stuck me in snowbanks and scooted me along frozen ponds because they wanted me to be a figure skater, but then I found hockey skates. I often find myself shouting in an ice rink, letting a French phrase or two wiggle from my lips like a true Canuck. I like me some Tim Hortons and poutine after a nice day of playing pond hockey, just so I can wash it down with some bagged milk, which doesn't taste any different than cartoned milk, but it's a novel concept, eh? I could skate before I could walk, and soon enough I was learning flying Vs before I knew the alphabet. Butterfly was a goaltending move, and icing sure as heck did not belong on cakes. Curling wasn't something girls did to their hair, and throwing sauce was something good. Gretzky and Lord Stanley were more common to me than legendary football coach Tom Osborne. Go Big Red means something else entirely for me, and the only thing I can think about on weekends is hockey night in Canada. When I was 4 years old, I went to a baseball game with my aunt, and I asked her where the penalty box was. I had no idea what was happening. The slow pace of America's pastime was just a little too lethargic for my taste. There were no exciting line brawls or empty net goals, just a bunch of grown men hitting at balls with sticks and then catching them with these mitts that they were touching each other with, and I thought that mitts were something you used to get pie out of the oven. 10 years later, I was following NHL playoffs and screaming, "Because it's the cup," in my sleep. The success of my team determined whether I was a happy or a raging teenage girl in the Rangers jersey and a toque, which Americans call beanies, and I didn't know that until middle school. Another thing I learned in middle school, stacking the pads means something different. My parents had this theory that I was incubated under the thick ice of Lake Ontario, nestled in an afghan made of maple leaf stitched together by Inuits, my hair carefully hidden by a knit cap crocheted by the wives of Albertan beef farmers, then lugged out of the frozen depths by moose and promptly fed maple syrup to make me a true Canadian. I can recite all 38 NHL teams and their captains. My sleep pattern depends on the New York Rangers schedule, and I'm unusually passionate about curling. If you say Husker, I hear hoser. Husker, hoser, Husker, hoser. If you say Kirby, I hear Hattie. Kirby, Hattie, Kirby, Hattie. If you say football, I don't care. Football don't care, football don't care. If you say hockey, I explode into 1,000 maple leaves. Hockey, maple leaves, hockey, maple leaves. If you say Nebraska, I hear home, because bean fields and sweet corn remind me that the 4th of July is the greatest time to be an American. Because even if I don't love football, my heart still skips a beat when I hear the pride of all Nebraska. Because home is not the place where you live. It's the place where the people you love are. But I've never longed for anywhere like I pine for the great white north.